Gunky, do you want to do this what do we call that? Disclaimer at the beginning of the show?
What's the disclaimer?
Well, the first thing is that if you're watching the video
right now,
yeah, this is not the show.
This is not the show. Okay. Baking up.
Yeah, stop thinking that this is the show and going to YouTube and watching this and going, wow, this is a funny video.
This is the behind the scenes kind of thing then.
Yeah, it's like we just, I don't know why, we record the video making it so that people can watch us live while we do the show. Kind of fun. Yep. If they want the real show, though, there's a place they can go. Harry, where's that?
HairCorInTheMore.com.
Is that a website?
It is.
What do you find over there?
Lots of fun stuff. You can go check out our page. We've got a Facebook or internet page there, and we've got all of our past podcast posts, and our last live feed is up there. Or if it's in time, you'll see the live feed right meow. And we've got our blog and our pants and contact info.
That's it. It's an audio program. Subscribe in iTunes if you want and never miss a show. The second part of the disclaimer, Gunky, is that Harry swears a lot. So if you got children in the room,
shit balls.
Yeah, get them out because Harry's going to go.
That's what I forgot to open.
You got to hit that beep button often.
All right, then. Shall we roll?
Harry hit the beat button all by himself. Didn't need to be reminded.
Just about. I got one thing I want to open up.
Okay. What is that? What does that mean? That's not it. Well, that's it.
HairCor!
In the more.
Good morning, Harry.
Morning, Corey.
Good morning, Gunky.
Howdy.
How did you guys sleep?
Unconsciously?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Not together, if that's what you're asking.
I didn't ask that. I'm guessing that you guys were in separate beds.
Yeah.
In the same room, though?
No. Bugger off, you smart ass.
I'm just asking. I mean, I just went on Skype, and there you both are. So, you know,
you're asking for it.
One can assume. I have to say, man, there was a lot of elements of last week's show that I really enjoyed.
It was a lot of fun, wasn't it?
It was a lot of fun. And you probably noticed that that wasn't my last show. I didn't quit.
No, you didn't. I thought you were gonna, but you didn't.
I was almost serious, too, at the end there.
You were not.
No, I'm never serious, but I pretty darn near had enough. I don't know why you want to make this show 90 minutes. That's too long.
Well, we never get everything said.
So you got Gunky in the dungeon there, who is the master gaming blogger on 10 Ton Hammer, and now amateur luthier, if you will.
Yeah, more or less, yeah.
What are you guys building over there?
Over here or at my place? Because Harry's got his own he's got his own project going on. his Chimera Strat. He calls it the Scaredy Strat. I call it the Chimera. That's his own thing.
The Scaredy Strat?
Yeah.
I like that.
I helped him with the wiring diagram that the thing came with was kind of, I don't know. There's you know how
amateur.
A little child would draw a house and say you were to use that for a blueprint to build an actual house. Yeah. That's essentially what this wiring diagram was. Like, it was horribly abstract and not at all accurate.
The picture's posted on our Facebook page, if anybody's curious.
Okay, so there's the HairCor and the More Facebook page now?
Yeah, there always was.
All right. I should show you sometime the wiring diagram I put together for the studio here. It sounds exactly like what I drew up.
I wouldn't doubt it.
How many axes are you got going on right now, Gunky?
Let me think. I got the Ghost Rider. That's the big, the Gretsch style. It's going to have flames on it. I got the Cowboy Strat. Technically, the Area Pro that I painted is still drying or curing and will be for a few months. And then there's the Westone. Japanese guitar that I'm kind of practicing my flame jobs on that one.
That sounds gross.
That's
what
she
said. It does sound gross, but in fact, it's actually even worse because I messed up the paint and I had to use paint stripper to take it all off, down to the wood because it was a really bad screw up. And then I tried to cover it with primer after, and the primer just ate away at the paint that was already on there. Just make, so it wasn't really didn't go very well. So I just stripped it all down, and I'm going to restart from the ground up.
But it sounds like you're kind of doing it, you know, and you're learning as you go.
Yeah, pretty much. And then I got a J base I'm working on, but that's going to be kind of my own project just for me. Take some time and do that just kind of proper. And I just got a bunch of parts today for a thin line Telecaster that I'm going to be building in kind of a steampunk style.
You're going to have like what, 17 guitars on the go?
Kind of, yeah. I think, what is that? What am I up to now? Is this five or six?
Five. Well, wait, we forgot the Series A. Or is it done technically?
Series A?
Yeah, the racing stripe. The yellow stripe.
And the Area Pro.
Area Pro, sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, so there's like six.
Six.
Is Series A even a company anymore?
I don't think so.
I haven't seen anything from them since the 80s.
No, I haven't seen it, no.
Like 1990.
Yeah.
Last one, it was before Selinger's was Selinger's. What was it before then?
That was Sorensen's.
Sorensen's, yeah. Back when it was still Sorensen's, they had Series A's on the wall.
I had a Series A once.
I had a Series A too. I think everybody had a Series A.
I sold my Series A to buy a Granada off a guy that sold it to somebody else on me, though.
He sold some shit to buy some more shit.
Yeah. And the other guy never sold me the guitar in the first place that he was supposed to.
I'm so jealous of you guys. I love tinkering with guitars, and following what you guys are doing on them has just been phenomenal from here.
Well, I had some issues with the double strat, the Scaredy strat.
Yeah.
I got to do some neck shaving on it yet. And
sounds gross.
We got to do some wiring. I'm going to rewire the whole thing.
Yeah. Scrap what's in there.
Cause yeah.
We got some sound to come out of it, but not the sounds you want to have come from the guitar.
But anyways, so that's kind of on hiatus till I get a new pickguard and the rest of the electronics for it that I want. And so I picked up some wood glue for the Les Paul, so I'm starting on that now.
So in short, there's two guys sitting around playing with their wood, shaving their necks, and doing flame jobs.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Got it.
More or less. And stripping. Yeah.
A lot of stripping.
You know, we...
A lot of stripping. You tone-deaf shirt hound.
So it's a bunch of deaf guys stripping their wood and shaving their necks. we talked a little bit in pre-show, and you rhymed off this crazy laundry list of all these topics that you want to talk about today. What do you got?
Well, we got our good old Chevette Chronicles back again, and okay. I got a product warning announcement. Let's hit that one up right now.
All right.
Anybody see those expandable/collapsible garden hoses that they've come out with? The X hose. They suck. Do not buy them. All the plastic and the components to them are cheap as hell, and they just fall apart on you.
X-hose.
Yes.
Well, I don't understand how this works. Explain.
Well,
this to
me. How do you call that? Like Kevlar when it's knitted or layered. What do you call that?
Woven.
Woven. Kind of, yeah, it's got a woven outer sheath, and inside there's this type of foam tube or plastic. Soft collapsible foam, and when you put the pressure on the water on the thing, expands and the hose goes from 15 feet to 50 feet.
Why would you want it to do that?
Because it's good for storage when it's empty.
You don't have to get that crank thing and wind it all up.
It's not heavy, it's really light. You got a 50 foot garden hose in the area of, like, I don't know, inside the area of my two fists.
Okay, so the idea is that we've been rolling our hoses since the dawn of mankind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And somebody said, you know what? I'm sick to death. Yeah. I'm sick of rolling my hose every damn day. I just want to turn the water on.
When you let the water pressure on.
God, this sounds weird. Okay, and then I just put the water, I turn the water on, and it just turns into a 50-foot hose. Do I hold it while it does that, or do I have to stand back?
You can hold it if you want to, if that's your kink.
Okay, so this thing then, so what's the problem with it? What didn't work?
The ends are plastic, and they put a valve on the end, an on-off turn valve, and it seems the levers just shoot right out of the things after you've used it three or four times.
Oh, interesting. Did you take it back?
Yeah.
Is this a Canadian Tire product?
I don't know who's, I think it was a television promoted thing.
I don't know.
One of them late night things. Anyway, someone in the family decided to go out and buy fucking six or seven of the things. And now it's systematically breaking down.
Who needs 350 feet of hose?
I do.
Are you a fireman?
I got a 350-foot yard.
Oh, that's right. You do have a lot of yard. Do you? What are you doing out there? Are you watering it?
Watering the dog.
Watering the dog?
Watering the dog, watering the lawn. No, not really watering the lawn. Like I said, all these things are breaking, so I've only got one of them that still works.
All right,
now.
So you've got a 50-foot round perimeter that's all green and lush and lovely, and then the rest of it is...
I'm not watering the lawns. It's not that bad.
Okay. All right. I don't understand what these songs are that you put in the Dropbox this week.
You don't understand. They're just songs.
I know they're songs and they're music and they're great, but I don't understand who this is.
I don't really know much about them either.
Okay.
I posted it on our website so you could get a little background.
Oh, so that means it's a gamble.
We have a website.
It's just a gamble.
It could be anything, man.
Oh, man.
You might have like the wobbles or something.
I'm going to go to the website.
It's, the band... the band's called Bastille, and let me just see here where they are from. London, England. Formed in 2010. I think this is their first album. Mm-hmm. And I ran onto them somewhere this week. I can't remember where I heard them, but...
That guy on the right there, the second from the right, he's a very fancy man. Look at him.
Yeah, I think that's the lead singer.
I think my bag broke again. I got flakes in my tea.
Anywho, I ran across them this week, and I kind of liked a couple of their songs, so I thought I'd share them with all our listenership out there. This is Bastille with Corey.
Laura Palmer.
Mm-hmm.
Followed by Bad Blood.
Ta-da!
My bag broke. All right. So if I take the tunes out of the Dropbox, you don't know what we're playing. That's awesome.
That's right.
That is so great.
I have a big head.
Fucking right you do.
HairCor.
Weirdo. Hey, it's funny looking.
It's like indie rocker, fancy man, indie rocker.
Perhaps sipping your cup of joe.
Stand by, Harold.
But something
10-4, Coral.
You hear a sound unlike one you've ever heard
before. At least I didn't play Daisy.
You realize that you may have stumbled upon the greatest audio discovery since the dawn.
There's nothing wrong with feeling it sometimes, you know? You get a tune in your head, you play it.
Harold.
So angry right now. I like that, but they kind of sounded the same.
They did. They got a style.
There's something that happened in British music, and you guys are free to disagree with me on this, but somewhere around 1992, all British songs started sounding exactly the same.
It's Oasis?
Kind of, yeah. And there was a lot of things going where, you know, if they weren't doing 16th notes on the hi-hat, which is a big British thing they would always do. They're like, yep. Just ticka ticka ticka. And now, if they weren't doing that, they were doing like sort of this pedal point bass line over top of this constant chord, you know. So they'd be hitting this one chord, wee 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 wee. Then underneath they'd be going do 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 do. And then it's just like,
sorry,
yeah, that's all British songs right there.
Well, and also don't forget that weird 4/4 time that everybody likes to play, like the Coldplay rhythm.
Yes, exactly. That's right. Yeah, that's their verse, and then they go to like a pedal point bass and a 16th note chorus.
It sounds like
I can catch a four, but I'm gonna do it really weird.
Yeah,
sounds like you're doing an Arnold Schwarzenegger impression for a minute.
Telling you, man.
Get down.
Do yourself a favor and listen to all the music that's come out of England in the last 20 years. It's all the same. I have nothing against the British. I just don't like them. You know,
he's just not holding any body parts up to them.
I'm sure they're all very sweet people.
I don't think they like you either.
No, I guarantee you they don't. I've gotten hate mail. Why?
Well, at the same time, for example, have you stopped showering again?
No, I just didn't shave today.
Okay, because I was just wondering, because you're talking about your nutsack smell and last week, and I'm like, oh, no, he stopped shaving again.
No. And it was because I was taking a pee, and my hand was in the area, and then I just gave it a little bit of a whiff.
Sure, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, buddy.
I'm not one of those self-suckers.
I don't even want to touch that.
Yeah. Hey, what color is the A-Team van? It's just black and red, right?
No.
No, sir. No,
what do you mean
sir?
No?
Can I?
Yeah, go ahead.
I've been arguing this for years.
You have this part of it.
I've been arguing this for years. Everybody's always trying to tell me, oh, it's black with a red stripe. Yeah. No. Yeah. It's fucking black on the bottom, then it has a red stripe, and then it's like a dark charcoal gray on metallic on the top.
Really?
Yeah. Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to have to look that up on the internet and see.
The reason I'm on Harry's side with this, Corey, you're going to like this. Have you ever seen a properly painted Darth Vader mask?
Okay, I like where this is going. which particular episode are we talking about? Because
all of them, every single one of them.
Okay, because didn't Vader's mask sort of change slightly?
Yes, it did. Okay, there's slight differences from, for example, from A New Hope, it had the Widow's Peak just above
right
the brow.
Yeah,
was sharper, and then they used it broke off or something between then and Empire Strikes Back. So the Empire Strikes Back and Jedi ones have a flatter. That point is flat instead of pointed.
That's right. And then episode 3 is the same helmet style as episode 4, right?
Episode 3? No. Episode 4, actually, they hand sculpted everything, right?
Yeah.
So there was a very slight difference between left side and right side. It wasn't perfectly symmetrical.
Cool.
In episode 3, when the whiny guy puts it on and says, no, that's... that's a very symmetrical mask, and it also looks much smaller.
We're talking about Thomas Jaden Hurst or
whatever his goddamn church. Hayden Christensen.
Sure.
Christmas.
The lenses are flat instead of bubbled. Like there's just a lot of little differences.
Mm-hmm.
The thing I'm talking about though.
Well, it's fair to say, first of all. I mean, let's get to the heart of it. I mean, it's got to get smelly in there. He's got to change his mask every couple of years. I'm sure of that.
Well, sure. And there's stunt ones that they sweat all in, and they have different parts cut out that are lenses. And then there's all kinds of different ones. But the hero mask that you see the close-ups of where David Prowse is wearing it on set, if you look really carefully, you can kind of tell it in when he's on the bridge of the Tantive IV in episode 4. When he turns his head, you can kind of, it looks just like helmet gleams, just the different facets gleaming in the light or whatever. But what it is that thing is painted kind of radially. If you imagine that all those little planes, all the little angles of it, each one is a different color. So it's not different. It's just black and silver.
But they alternate.
They alternate, yeah. So like the top of his one cheek will be black, and then the face of that cheek will be silver. And then the part above the mouth, the kind of rounded part, will be black again. And then the tusk will be silver, and it goes on and on like that. The neck part like this is actually all silver.
This is amazing. I now have to go and do some research. So now you're telling me
And it's the same thing with the A-Team van. Everybody had such a bad, crappy TV back in the day when we were watching A-Team that everybody just assumed it was black, red, black.
Yeah.
But it's dude, I've been arguing with people for years. It's a charcoal gray on top. Metallic.
Wow, that's interesting. I'm sure online we can find some nice high-definition photos of it, though, right?
Yep. Well, if you, I already have found them. I can post one.
Do a Google search for like Darth Vader mask paint, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. How they alternate the colors. It's that blew my mind when I learned about that.
It blew my mind too.
Yeah.
we gotta get Gunky on all the time. That's awesomeness. I'm gonna try and do a segment, even though I have a sore throat. Is that cool?
Go ahead.
All right. All right. What do we got here?
Well, hey! Welcome back to another edition of HairCor in the Moor. We're going to play one of my favorite games, Get the Tune. I love this one because I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to sing the song, but I'm not going to sing it. I'm just going to sing the lyrics to Harry over there, and he's going to get the name of the song.
I got a fast car.
Stop. Tracy Chapman?
No.
Carry on.
Why would I say in the first line, the name of the team?
I don't know. You're trying to throw me off.
Go cruising down the highway. A Corvette Stingray. I do it my way.
Turn me loose.
Yep. By Loverboy.
Nope.
Nope?
Nope.
Okay, I'm wrong.
Got a good job. Making lots of money. I look good. And I'm funny. So why am I so lonesome, honey?
I know, I was going to say, honey's got to come over here soon. Damn it, I know this. Start again.
Start again?
No, I'm just kidding.
I'll start again.
I had a trigger early on. I wanted to get it off the original trigger.
Do you want me to, do you really want me to start again?
Got a fast car.
We've never started again.
Okay, keep going.
The gypsy said, the problem with you, you need some.
Is it ZZ Top?
No. Look at this black book. It's loaded with phone numbers. Potential lovers. New worlds to discover. You would think I really have it made now. New Ray-Ban shades. But I'm a heartache on parade now. I walk around with the blues. I need some.
Good loving?
No.
Is it Van Halen?
No. You're close, though.
How's close? What's close to Van Halen? David Lee Roth?
Correct.
Oh.
Out of my element here. I have no idea.
Give you. Damn it. Okay, keep going.
Ones that will lead me back to you. Because you're the only lover who was ever true. I need some. All my friends now, they look up to me. They wish they could be a lot more like me. But they don't know, and they can't see, how I'm hurting, how I'm empty. Lost my soul when I walked out on you. I need some.
God damn it.
Ones that will lead me back to you.
Something about shoes.
There you go.
Oh, comfortable shoes?
Nope.
Damn it.
Gunky's half right, though.
Something about shoes and what? What'd you say?
That's all. Something about shoes. It has to rhyme with blues. Or whatever. All the use, you, whatever he's saying. Something, something shoes. I don't know any.
Do you guys give up?
Songs. No.
All right. I got a fast car. Go cruising down the highway. I'm not starting again, by the way. This is just
sensible shoes.
Correct.
Jesus Christ.
Wow.
God damn it.
You got a lot wrong before you got anything close to right. That's awesome.
Right. That's okay.
Just when I'm about to give up on this game.
I can live with it.
Yep. Holy cow, we got like very little time. So I suggest, and I don't know if you want to, but I really like it when you tell me stories.
Okay.
Will you tell me a story, Daddy? Tell me about your car.
I'll tell you about mine. The garage, Mom. Look at my fucking garage.
Swear to God, singing that at the top of his goddamn lungs, we're cruising through Kitchener. I'm embarrassed. I'm rolling up the windows, trying not to be heard, and he's trying to have a smoke, singing that. I'm like, I don't know this fella. I just picked him up at the bus.
He's a hitchhiker.
His name is Hank, I think. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, the Chevette Chronicles. Okay, so where we last left is we've got the Sony deck in the dash now and Boston acoustics all the way around. 400 watts of power. Cruising around having a blast on zero dollars of gas.
Can I stop you for a second?
No. Yes.
Okay, because if you're talking about the wattage of the amplifiers, the 1 ohm amp, I think think the Omega in the for the subs was 1,000-watt amp alone.
No, they're both 200 watts, dude.
The subwoofer amp?
Yep.
The mono sub amp was 200 watts.
But because we bridged it, it made it half ohm stable. So it was acting like an 800-watt amp.
God, that's sexy. Okay, sorry, carry on.
Yes. So that's where we last left it. And one of my favorite stories about that car and that stereo with you was the Sony Deck in-dash CD player that I had a Walkman jack input, like one of those little half-inch headphone jacks, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember what we plugged into it one night and drove around Listowel?
It was a guitar, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And I was doing solos and stuff.
Yeah, we're driving around town with the windows open. You were playing guitar in the Chevette.
That's awesome.
It was awesome. The only thing was we didn't have any way to hook a distortion pedal up.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember how it sounded because it couldn't have been good. It's just a dry guitar into a car stereo.
Yeah, it was kind of clean.
Like there were no little mini pocket zooms or anything you could have brought with you at that time.
Not back then, no.
No, you had to get like a Marshall head and find a way to like rank it down to like 10 watts so that you wouldn't blow your car stereo. It was impossible. Well, you couldn't do it.
I think you could do it at 14. Okay. At 14 amps. But what we should have done was had like a little distortion pedal with a battery in it. That might have worked.
Would have done it. Yeah.
Yeah,
just a little stomp box with a 9-volt in it. Where were you?
And one other little story. That car saved us a ticket one night too, didn't it?
Are you talking about how? Well, maybe this wasn't this car, because I remember if you were ever driving around. And you had any weed that instead?
No, not that time.
Oh, okay.
No, I think we had some weed that night too, but I don't want to say the other two guys' names or three other guys' names.
Yeah.
But you and I, we did a. Oh, let's save that for next week. Okay. We should talk about this before we tell this story.
Oh, but I don't want to go to bed.
Well, I'm going to finish this story.
Okay.
Anyways, now this was after one of our nights because we never smoked pot at home. We always, back in high or college or after college, we went out to the countryside to smoke pot,
okay,
right?
Okay, well, let's slow down here. We never actually smoked pot. We would sometimes, you know, have weed around and we would look at it and giggle.
Well, you see, I never did.
Okay.
Ever. Yeah. And I used to drive you guys in your car. So you could look at it and giggle.
That's right. I used to sit in the back seat and look at it and giggle while you drove me around.
Yeah, because you guys didn't want to drive a giggling.
You were the best friend.
Yeah. Anyways, down the road, I got into it too, started giggling.
It's funny to look at.
Yep. And like, what's with these leaves?
Yeah, it's all green, funny smelling.
We were out one night, the night before. We got pulled over and we were doing some bad stuff. Like I was notorious for finding great places to, let's say, park for a better choice of words.
Yeah, you better look for a better choice of words, because now it just sounds like you and I were gonna bag of grass, go out into a field and park.
Which in actual truth, that's what we did.
Technically, technically
we were parking. Anyways, so the next night, thank God I washed my car that day, because I think we found in a couple of gravel pits that we were driving through in a bunch of fields and stuff. Anyways, I washed the car that day. And then the next night, you and I were out again in the same township driving around.
Oh, this is coming back to me.
And we came up to a stop sign and I saw a set of headlights coming over the hill from the right. And I'm like, we're not in any hurry. We'll just wait for this car to go by. I don't care how far away he is.
Mm-hmm.
The car crests the hill and the flippers come on. Yeah. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Yeah.
And he cranks it in front of us and locks it up. Does this big skid halt. And in front of us, we're just sitting there. You know, we were already stopped, dude.
Yeah, it's like you didn't really have to chase us.
No. He comes up to the car and he says, "What are you boys doing?" "Oh, well, we're just, you know, adjusting my stereo in here. You know, I got a new stereo in here. And I'm just, you know, tweaking it and getting it tuned in. He's like, oh, you got one of them big power amps, do you?
Which, by the way, which, by the way, is the greatest thing to say to a cop when you're out in the late at night driving around on country roads. It's like, I wanted to crank my stereo up and I don't want to bug anybody in town.
That's exactly what I said, right? I said, you wouldn't want me to have this thing blaring in town because it's going to rattle everybody's windows.
There you go. You're a good citizen.
And he's like, so we totally distracted him with that conversation, got him talking about the car stereo. Saved. And then he looked at the car. He says, well, we were looking for somebody that's been doing a bunch of fielding and driving in gravel pits. And he looked at my car, the side of my car. He says, you guys haven't been in gravel pits or fields lately, have you? And I'm like, hell no. I didn't tell him and I washed the car that day.
No, no.
So the stereo got us out of a ticket to a lesser extent.
I think the stereo has saved us on a number of occasions.
It had.
I miss that a lot. We used to go and listen to a lot of records.
We did. It was like there was nothing better to do than just hop in the Chevette, crank the tunes, and just listen to tunes and giggle.
Well, I think in all fairness, we didn't look for anything better to do. You know.
I guess so.
Thank you, man. I appreciate these stories so much. They just, they're so good. They're good brain jigglers.
My pleasure.
Okay. Can I play some tunes and then we'll see if we can get an American on the phone?
No. Of course.
Oh, thanks, man. I'm gonna go back into the old catalog here and yank out two songs that I really dig from the Counting Crows. This is Children in Bloom and then Up All Night.
From your communist bitch Nazi.
From the... Oh, you is funny. You is funny. You.
It's the best of what's their faces.
Smoke break.
Sure.
Maybe the comic is just that a big
one. Any of them is pretty funny.
They're all pretty good. And you can mix them up, too.
All right, guys, you want to pick five then?
Yep, five.
Okay, I'll reload my water. I'll be back in a bit.
Yeah. We'll be right back. Hey, 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 hey. What's happening?
Not a whole lot, sir. You?
Doing quite well.
Excellent. So you're on when Corey left.
No, I'm here.
Did you leave?
Oh, oh, there he is.
I'm here. I'm having now I'm having a hot lemon water.
You'll never again return to ordinary, less effective ways.
All right, stand by, folks. I was just dipping back, man, and I did those tunes. I don't know why.
It's a good band.
It's a good band, you know, and they've had a solid career, and they've got some good records out there.
It's all subjective.
Yeah. you know what I did, guys? I got on the phone, and I found another American.
Another one?
Yeah, check it out. Canadian Dream. Edward by Well, the singer. Gregerson,
coach.
How you doing, man?
Doing good. How are you guys?
Good. Welcome back to the show. Appreciate you coming on.
Good. Hi, Dave. I brought my friend here, Jeff, with me.
What up, Jeff? How's it going?
Good, man.
Are you a fellow Canadian?
Yeah.
Good. So maybe you can answer some of these questions for us tonight.
We'll give it a shot. I'll see what I can come up with here.
Lay it on us, man.
All right, I thought we'd do something a little bit different. I have about 15 questions, so I'm going to this is gonna be like a rapid fire. You got to be on your game here, okay?
You know, this is only an hour show.
What?
What's that?
It's only an hour show, despite what Harry wants.
They're really easy. You got to be really fast.
Okay.
All right, we'll see how many you get here. You guys ready?
I'm ready.
Yep. All right. Here we go. Who was the first Canadian Boy Scout?
Robert Baden-Powell.
Correct. Who is the richest Canadian music artist?
Celine Dion.
Correct. What's Canada's approximate population?
35 million.
35 million. Correct. What year did the national anthem, O Canada, become official?
1980.
1960.
Correct.
What? That?
1980. What's the oldest corporation in North America?
Hudson's Bay Company.
That is correct. What year was the red and white maple leaf adopted as the official flag?
Oh, that was 1965.
Correct.
What's going on? You guys set this up. This is a setup.
What hockey
this is
legend
not
recorded his 2,857th NHL point?
I'm leaving.
That could only be Wayne Gretzky.
You're making this up.
That is correct.
You guys sat together. You guys. Like,
what year did
funny.
The CFL make its home in Canada?
1958.
Correct. Who was the first Canadian to win the main event of the World Series of Poker?
I got this one. Jonathan.
To Hamill.
Yeah.
Yep.
That is correct. Who was the toughest guy Muhammad Ali was quoted to fight?
Oh, that was the Canadian. That was George Chivalo.
Chivalo.
That is correct. Five more questions. What year was the first NBA game played in Canada?
Oh, wasn't that in 1946 with the Toronto Huskies versus the New York Knickerbockers?
Very good. Correct. In 1959, who patented the alkaline battery?
That was another Canadian. Louis Urey, I think.
That is correct. In 1910, John A.D. McCurdy becomes the first Canadian to receive what?
His pilot's license?
That is correct. Who made the first American flag?
The beaver.
What is Canada's national animal?
Betsy Ross.
That is correct.
I got a couple questions here. Who's the cheatinest motherfucking Canadian I've ever known? How many people can a co-host unfriend during a program? How much does a guy really hate conspirators who get together ahead of the show and try and make an ass of me? You're all a bunch of vaginas, all of y'all.
You're fine, prick omelet.
Damn it. How did you manage to take the fun out of this segment for me?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, you guys.
Yeah, what are you talking about, man? I just know my shit.
Two little bitches on the phone, head of the show, like a little fucking sewing circle. It's like, we're going to get Corey on this one.
Thanks for your help, Jeff, as much as Corey attests.
I didn't even get one of those right.
Good job, Jeff.
Assholes.
Good job, Dave.
Goodbye, David.
Thank you. Hey, good job, Harry.
Thank you very much. That was awesome.
Get off my show.
Hey, we'll do it again next week.
No, we won't. Excellent. You're done. You're done. And then despite you, I'm going to keep doing the show, even though I said I'm going to quit next week, and you can't come back.
That hurts.
I'm going to find some guy from fucking Florida.
That really hurts.
I'm sorry,
that's,
man.
That's awfully rude, man.
I don't mean that. I love you. I'm just angry.
Mm. You didn't get one of those, right?
What? I didn't...
The richest Canadian music artist.
I didn't have a chance to answer because you guys were staging your little shoe.
Why don't you didn't get that one?
Why don't you guys go get your own podcast? Why don't you get that? It should be the Dave and Harry Fuck Gory Show.
The national animal? You know that one?
Yeah. It's the jackass. I can see him on my monitor right now. Go away. Go away. Get off my show.
All right, guys.
Thanks, Dave.
I'm gonna finish sucking down these beers.
Mm. All right.
I'm so mad at all of y'all right now. I'm just gonna make you
say y'all.
You're done. Get off. Hey, thanks, Dave. That was amazing.
All right, buddy. Have a good one.
I'll talk to you tomorrow.
It's time for another episode from your favorite guys at HairCor in the Mall presents. It's time for the queen, not so queen, to read some Zedlep lyrics for you.
Did he say Zedlep?
Guess which track the queen is reading to.
She's going to go to hell.
Anyways, it's time to get on with it. Let's hear
I'm not good at anything. I don't want this.
You're going to do it all right.
I don't care what you say.
Yeah, get over there right
get
now.
Get out of my face.
No, get over there.
Get lost. I told you, go away. Out of here.
Get over here and do this.
You guys are weird.
Weird, you bitty old bit.
I don't know what I'm doing.
You said it. When light goes down, I see no reason for you to cry. We've been through this before. In every time, in every season, God knows I've tried. So please don't ask for more. Can't you see it in my eyes? This might be our last goodbye. Things, they change, my friend. Maybe we'll meet again. I read your mind. With no intentions of being unkind. I wish I could explain. It all takes time. A whole lot of patience. If it's a crime, how come I feel no pain?
Are you still there?
Yep.
That's all of them.
Are you done now? Are you done?
I'm done.
Reading the lyrics to Carrie by Europe.
Yeah. How come we didn't interject?
I was enjoying it.
Okay.
Like, I was kind of sitting back, just digging you, talking to me. It was nice.
Good job.
Thanks. And I just went on the internet and Googled the first couple of lyrics and cheated.
Oh.
Two can play that game, fucker.
Sucker, you see?
I have the internet here.
I have a big head.
Big head. 65% of workers in cubicles report they spend 80% of their time reading email.
Reading email.
I'm having a hot lemon water now. We got about 3.5 minutes, and that's I've got that much voice left.
I think Jeff's got a question for you.
Yeah, I got a theoretical kind of, you just won a contest, okay? Let's say Corey won a contest. And you get to pick one of three cars as your prize. There's Bob Barker. He's got three keys for you, and you got to pick one. The first set of keys is for Kit, the car from Knight Rider.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Second set of keys is for Magnum PI's Ferrari GTS, 380 GTS.
Mm.
Third key is for the A-Team van. Go.
Okay. How many miles are on the Kit car right now?
I mean,
none.
Let's say they're all factory, like right off the factory floor.
Yeah. Oh, I want Kit.
You want Kit?
I want Kit. Yeah, no question. No question. Just, I mean, it's always good to have a friend. One. Two, he kicks the butt of any GPS.
He could. Yeah.
Three, I mean, you can just like totally suck down a beer and say, Kit, take it.
Okay.
What are you going to do in the A-Team van? Does it come with all
the A-Team van? It's got guns and shit in the back.
Oh, has it got all the gear in it? All their stuff?
And it's a shaggin' wagon.
Maybe.
See, okay, here's my perspective on the whole thing. As far as cars go, nothing beats European design and construction and performance. I love the 380 GTS. Yeah. As far as drivability goes,
I'm taking
it's totally that car.
I'm taking the Magnum PI car, man.
But my problem is the other two are GM products, so they both ride horribly bad. And I want the van. I want A-Team's van, man. That's so BA. It's badass.
Yeah. We got three people, three different answers. That's kind of the way that question goes.
That's interesting, though. I guess, I don't know, when I was a kid, I really loved Knight Rider. And I dreamed a lot about that car. And I had like a Hot Wheels Knight Rider car and everything. A-Team was awesome, but it wasn't the van that was awesome to me. It was just the A-Team. I was a big Murdoch guy. Who's your favorite A-Team guy?
I was a Murdoch guy, too, but BA's awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
Hannibal. Face is great too. So is Hannibal.
Hannibal's the man.
Yeah, Hannibal's the man.
He's the man with the plan. He loves it when a plan comes together. Yeah. That's his whole thing.
What did he always say? Oh, he's on the jazz.
Do you know, the intro to Magnum PI is one of the reasons why I started playing guitar.
Yeah. Oh yeah. That's why I'm going for the Magnum PI car, because you cruise around blasting that out of the speakers of that son of a bitch.
Yep. That palm muted back and forth. That's why I started playing guitar, because of that sound.
Or if you had a Boston acoustic stereo system in your 380 GT with a Sony deck with a mic, a headphone jack in it, you could plug your own guitar into it, and I could play the Magnum PI theme while you drove around.
Nobody said I could mod these things. Good morning, Harry.
Morning, Corey.
Good morning, Gunky.
Morning, Corey. Morning, Harry.
Morning. Morning, Gunky.
In the more.
Should we redo that tale?
We sure could.
Yeah, we should, because Jeff got interrupted when he asked me good morning.
All right, let's recut that. We'll say good morning to everybody.
You drove around.
Nobody said I could mod these things. Good morning, Harry.
Good morning, Corey.
Good morning, Gunky.
Good morning, Corey.
Good morning, Gunky.
Good morning, Harry.
That's too funny. Oh, my goodness. Wow, man. Gunky Jeff. So good to have you on the show, bro.
Yeah. Always a pleasure.
Yes.
Yeah, I was afraid he was going to back out on us there for a little while. It's like, no, you got to come on the show. We got to talk about the guitars.
Oh, it's always good to have a third person in.
Magnum PI and A-Team.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that whole thing about the A-Team van came up because I'm thinking about, I want to do a base like that, paint a base like with the A-Team, like the red stripe and then the gray top and the black bottom. Oh, and something cool. Something that emulates the spoiler in the back and the KC lights. And Big Mag wheels instead of volume knobs.
Hey, what was that guitar in the 80s that had, it was kind of a square body, and then it had a plastic arm that came up and around the top and attached to the
headstock. Oh, like that synth. It was a synth guitar, wasn't it?
Yeah, you know the ones I mean.
Yeah.
But they were like a KCO or something?
Sort of.
No, it was a fly. It was a something fly.
No, it wasn't a Parker fly. It was,
wasn't a Parker fly?
No, no, no. But and there were ones that were just electric guitars that had that cool plastic handle on. It's like that thing might be cool to mod like an A-Team thing.
Oh. I was thinking like the pickup cover for like a J-Bass, or even I think they make it for the P-Bass too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like the chrome pickup cover. And you paint that and then you extend it up. But I mean, you want to have something that looks like the spoiler. And I'm not sure what I would do for that. I would have to make something a bolt on piece that goes around up at the top, and then you thread the strap through it.
I can't visualize it. I can't get this guitar out of my mind. It's going to drive me nuts until I find it.
Yeah, I Googled it, and so far I've got Steve Vai's Heart guitar.
Oh, yeah. it's such a weird... Oh, man. And it'll come to me. I know the name of the thing.
It's kind of like a Steinberger, but it looks more like a Parker Fly. It's like that keyboard right there, but the arm goes up off the main horn and then it down on a 45 angle to the headstock.
What?
Oh, I found it.
Did you?
I found it.
I found it.
Hang on, let me pull this guy up. There we go.
Where's that McMars?
No, that's Batten. That Batten guy.
I found it. Whoops. Forward. Whoops, 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 whoops. Oh, fuck off.
What is it?
I'm just going to send you a really good link here.
Okay.
Guitar. And then I accidentally hit too many backs, and now I'm lost. Ah, la 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 la, images.
That's a cool headstock, Jeff. Look at that.
Snakehead one? That's kind of funny.
Okay. Google
that. I was like, what's... Google, I know. The guitar player from Great White had a dinky body, what was shaped into a shark's mouth. And the neck was the dude's leg, and the headstock was like a sock and a Converse sneaker.
Oh, Lord.
That was a funky guitar. Do you remember that one, Corey?
I do. Here, let me move you back out of my other window here. Come on, you. Where'd you go?
Look at that thing.
I got too many things going on here. Hang on. I'm going to stop the video recording.